Hello everyone and welcome. In today's video, I'll go over Beastmastery Hunter Arena playstyle and comps in BFA. The footage we'll be using today is from Weedy, one of the top BM hunters in EU. This video will also contain updated talents, Azerite traits and stats so you can create pressure for your team with the right talent choices. The best comps for Beastmastery Hunter are Jungle Cleave and PHP. Jungle Cleave is an aggressive comp with good CC, good burst damage, off healing and a lot of spread pressure if you want to cleave multiple targets down at once. Both Hunter and Feral Druid have a lot of mobility to connect onto most targets, so keeping up pressure as this comp is fairly easy. PHP has a lot of burst damage but weaker sustained damage than Jungle Cleave. However, the off healing and big cooldowns the Red Paladin brings makes this comp really tanky versus most melee cleaves and allows you to eventually score the kill. Unfortunately, PHP performs weaker than Jungle Cleave against Spell Cleaves, since the Paladin will have to play defensive for the majority of the game. For your talents, your standard build will look like this. Some talents can be swapped depending on what comp you face. For example, Natural Mending can be swapped out for Camouflage when facing a Rogue to try and find the Rogue in stealth to stop the opener from the enemy team. Post Haste can be swapped out for Binding Shot when facing a melee cleave to have an extra route to root both melees. Binding Shot can also be used versus Priest teams if you won't need the extra mobility from Post Haste. This way you can root the kill target with Binding Shot, since a rooted target can't get crypt away by Leap of Faith. For your PvP talents, you always want to play Gladiator's Medallion, since you can rotate your trinket both defensively or offensively with your team. As human, you could choose to play Relentless instead, since you still have every man for himself to get yourself out of stuns. There's one PvP talent that should always be played, which is Dire Beast Basilisk. To get the maximum value out of your Basilisk, use it off a Binding Shot or Tar Trap, so it can catch up to enemies. Basilisk is one of your biggest damage abilities, but it's easily kited, so it's important that the kill target is slowed. Now let's take a look at the situational PvP talents. Wild Protector should be used versus melee cleaves, since your pet will always be close to the target that's being trained, which means they will take 10% less damage for the majority of the game. Another talent to use versus melee cleaves is Roar of Sacrifice. Roar of Sacrifice gives your team another defensive cooldown to make the target immune from taking a critical strike for 12 seconds. Versus Spell Cleaves, there are 4 talents to choose from: Spider Sting, Survival Tactics, Roar of Sacrifice and Dragon Skill Armor. Roar of Sacrifice and Survival Tactics are both good options versus bursty casters like Destruction Warlocks, Boomkins and Mages. Spider Sting and Dragon Skill Armor are both good options versus Dot Cleaves. Spider Sting can be used to silence an enemy player for 4 seconds after they use an offensive spell. High Explosive Trap can be used on maps like Playchatch Arena, Mugambala or even Dalaran to knock players away defensively or offensively. When facing a rogue mage team, the best talents are Roar of Sacrifice and Spider Sting. This way you can stop the mage from doing an offensive setup with Spider Sting and use Roar of Sacrifice on burst windows from the enemy team. You need 3 pets for PvP as Beastmastery. One pet of the Rodent family with the Cunning spec, which will give you a Mortal Strike effect and Master's Call to get your heal out of Root Beam from Boomkins or simply to kite. This is your default pet. The second pet is a Mana Saber found in Suramar with the Tenacity spec, which will give you an offensive dispel and a heal from Spirit Mend. This pet should be used versus Disc Priest teams and Holy Pally teams to purge shields and Blessing of Protection. The third pet is a Ferocity Scorpion found pretty much anywhere, for example in front of Orgrimmar, which gives you and your pet 15% leech, which is very good versus rot comps, for example Shadowplay. For your Azerite traits, Primal Instincts offers the most burst damage and should be stacked 3 times if possible. Additionally, you can also choose to use one Battlefield Focus, since it also works for your team and pets. If you find yourself dying a lot, you can choose to use a defensive trait like Azerite Veins or Azerite Fortification instead. Tidal Surge, Resonant Fury and Laser Matrix are all pretty close to each other, so pick your pieces based on if they have other good traits apart from Primal Instincts. For the best damage output, your stat priority is this: get at least 20% crit, get 10-12% haste, and Mastery and Versatility are equal in value, so after hitting the crit and haste goal, pick pieces with Mastery and Versatility on them. As a Beastmastery Hunter, you focus on setting up CC chains, positioning, peeling, and setting up kill potentials to create pressure for your team. The playstyle goals for Beastmastery Hunter are create pressure, positioning, peel, and kite. These playstyle goals apply to nearly every comp, and applying them will help you to improve your gameplay as a Beastmastery Hunter. create pressure. Beastmastery's damage comes from their burst. In order to create pressure for your team, it's important that you set up a CC chain and create pressure as soon as possible. Jumping into the start of the game, we can see the hunter moves in for an aggressive opener. Before going for CC, you should get your Basilisk out as seen in this clip. The Feral lands a bash on the enemy healer, and you can then follow up with a trap after. Since the game started with an aggressive opener, the Shaman uses his Trinket and Astral Shift, and the Boomkin already uses Barkskin, which is a lot of cooldowns to force right at the start of the game. When the enemy team is under a lot of pressure, and you still have your burst active, simply applying a ton of pressure can be enough to score a kill without having to use your CC. Another way to create pressure for your team is by swapping onto a healer when they use the big cooldown to help their teammates survive. For example, Blessing of Sacrifice from Paladin, Pain Suppression from Priest, or Ironbark from Druid. By swapping onto the enemy healer when a big cooldown has been forced, you can stop the enemy healer from topping their teammate and maybe even open up a swap window if you force another cooldown from the enemy healer. Keep in mind that every healer has an ability to try and avoid traps. Resto Shamans have Grounding Totem, Resto Druids and Mistweaver Monks have their mobility, and Holy Paladin has Blessing of Sacrifice, and Priest has Premonition. This means you can play on top of the enemy healer to bait a cooldown like Grounding Totem, Blessing of Sacrifice, or Premonition without even using your trap. When they use a spell like Premonition or Grounding Totem, you can then follow up with a trap anyway. Sometimes the pressure of the enemy healer thinking you will get trapped or interrupted is enough to force a cooldown or score the kill. Positioning. Since Beastmastery's main damage comes from their pets, positioning is a big part of playing Beastmastery Hunter. By playing around the pillar, you can still put out a lot of pressure while avoiding CC and swaps onto you. Poor positioning can easily cost you the game, which can be avoided by utilizing the pillar. Jumping into the next clip, we can see the priest gets caught in a CC chain. By using the pillar to line of sight while your healer is in CC, you can still apply pressure with your pets while your team saves all their cooldowns. In the next clip, we can see how you can use your mobility to line of sight the enemy team before dropping to low health on burst windows. This can save yourself or your healer a ton of cooldowns, and you should try to line of sight as much as you can when trap is on cooldown, or when the enemy team pops a big offensive cooldown like Incarnation from a Boomkin. Jumping into the next clip, we can see how you can utilize your pet damage while maintaining a good positioning. The Feral lands a stun on the enemy healer, and you can then push in and follow up with a trap. Once the CC lands, you can position yourself near a pillar again, so you can line of sight damage and CC if needed, while still being able to damage with your pets. Try to position yourself at a pillar as much as possible when trap is on cooldown, since it will make it harder for the enemy team to land CC or swaps onto you, while you're still able to put out pressure on the enemy team. Peel. When your team gets pressured instead, it's important to peel for your team with roots, slows, traps, and stunts. Roar of Sacrifice can be used to peel yourself or your partners during offensive cooldowns from the enemy team. In this clip, we can see how to utilize your Master's Call when facing a Boomkin. You can use your Master's Call to free your healer out of a root solar beam to avoid having to use any cooldowns. Additionally, Master's Call can also be used to kite the enemy team when under pressure. You can also peel for your team by using your Binding Shot to root the enemy team, Intimidation to stun a DPS, or even your Freezing Trap to peel a DPS when under a lot of pressure. Kite. When you're under pressure instead, you can use your mobility spells to kite while your team peels for you. In this clip, we can see how you can use your mobility to kite with Disengage. By kiting while your healer is in CC, you can save cooldowns or potentially even avoid dying by avoiding damage. In this clip, we can see how you can use your Tar Trap to kite the enemy team. Just by running close to your Tar Trap while the enemy team has to run through it can be enough to stabilize or to get away from the enemy team. Additionally, you can kite with Aspect of the Cheetah, Master's Call, and even with Binding Shot if you still have issues with kiting the enemy team after using Disengage and Tar Trap. That's gonna be it for this guide, guys. Please leave a plus skill if you enjoyed it and let me know what you think in the comments. And I'll see you guys next time.